Rotating outages are possible if usage does not go down this week, but the real trouble spot is between 3 p.m. and 7 p.m. That's when peak usage occurs and the demand is exceeding the supply.
The Electric Reliability Council of Texas, or ERCOT, issued a stern warning to Texans today, asking them to cut down on their usage of lights, appliances, and anything electric that they can do without. If not, the alert could elevate to emergency levels, prompting rotating outages of up to 45 minutes.
Not long enough that the house would get extremely hot, but long enough to cycle that peak and lower it throughout the entire system.
Locally, Encore Electric Delivery Manager Sue Mercer says that the strong economy and solid income levels can lead people to keep their air conditioning very cool, which stresses the system. Mercer also points to the sustained heat across the state as added weight on the electric grid, which is now feeling the pressure.
High temperatures are sustaining longer periods of time this year, so it's affecting not just the peak, but it's also affecting total usage.
This week's peak usage breaks the previous record set last summer. Mercer says all-time records are broken almost every year because the population of Texas continues to grow, and more people means more electricity demand.
But when you've got more households, then it sets a new overall peak for the entire system.
To conserve, you're asked to turn off all unnecessary lights and unplug appliances you aren't using. You can close your blinds or put up curtains to block heat from your rooms and set your thermostat to 78 degrees or higher. Using the microwave instead of the electric range or oven can also save energy.
If you can plan to do that instead of the entire grid going down, it's a much better situation.
Now, ERCOT is buying an additional 800 megawatts of power from states east of the Rockies and 200 from Mexico. For reference, 1 megawatt can power about 200 homes. They're asking Texans to reduce usage all week during the hours of 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. and especially between 4 and 5 o'clock. Reporting in the studio, Beau Berman, CBS 7 News.